Children, this is your English period, so I would request everyone to kindly take out your English literature books and get ready for the session. Children, today we are going to start with the chapter number 4, that is, chapter is Sikkim. Alright? Children, we have already did our half-yearly exams. And 50% of our syllabus is already completed, okay, and we are now entering into the new phase, that is, we are preparing for UT2 exams, okay. So before beginning with the chapter Sikkim, I would like to introduce you with the map of India. Children, we live in which country? We live in India, okay. And India has 28 states and 8 union territories. You might have studied in GK. In class 2 also, you might have studied about states and union territories and its capitals. And in class 3 also, you might have learned. So children, Sikkim, the chapter which we will cover today in this session, Sikkim is a state. So I would show you, this is the map of India, and I would show you where Sikkim is situated in our country. So you can, I have zoomed the picture and you can see here Sikkim. All right, this small part of our country just near Bhutan. Okay, you can see Bhutan ke bagal mein beta aap dekh rahe hoge. Pink color ka part hai, that is Sikkim, and the capital of Sikkim is Gangtok. Okay, Sikkim is a state and its capital is Gangtok. So this we are going to learn in this session about our one state, that is Sikkim. Children, Sikkim is located in eastern area of our country, that is northeast. You might have learned about directions in EVS subject. So there are 4 main directions and 4 sub directions, right? So Sikkim is located in which part of direction? That is, Sikkim is located in northeast region of our country. So that's it. About the location and the position it holds in our country. So today we are going to start with this.
I have opened the index page, that is contents, where chapters, all the chapters of this chapter are written on the first page. So children, the chapters which I have ticked here, we have already completed, and these chapters have already came in half yearly exams. So as I have discussed that we are entering into a new phase, that is, we are prepping for UT2 exams. So we are going to start with chapter 4, Sikkim. Okay, and these 6 chapters which I have ticked, that is chapter 6, chapter number 6, chapter number 5, chapter number 3, poem 1, chapter 2 and chapter 1. These chapters are not going to come in UT2 exams and final exams. Okay, so Sikkim chapter is on page 31. So children, kindly open page 31. All right children, so let's begin with the chapter. Chapter number 4, Sikkim. So before starting the chapter, I would request every child to hold a pencil and put a finger where I am reading. So children, in this way, you will be able to listen the correct pronunciation of the words which I am going to tell you. And also, in between where I will find any difficult word coming in the chapter, I am going to underline it and write the meaning of the same above the word. Okay, so you have to do the exact way as I am doing. So before you read, do you know the names of all the states of India? So earlier in this video I have shown you the map of India where all the states and union territories were given. So how many states do we have in our country, children? There are 28 states. All right, which are the 8 northeastern states of India? So children, as we have discussed already, I am going to tell you the main 4 directions. You might have learnt in chapter directions in EVS subject. So what are the 4 main directions? Which are the 4 main directions? Are north, south, east and west. And what are the 4 sub directions? Children, total directions are 8. 4 main directions and 4 sub directions. So the 4 sub directions are north and northeast ke beech mein beta we have northeast direction, south and east ke beech mein beta we have southeast direction, south and west ke beech mein we have southwest direction, north and west ke beech mein beta we have northwest direction. So children, 4 main directions are north, south, east, west, and sub directions are northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest. Beta, this is N and this is W in case it is not clear in the video. So we have northwest direction, southwest, southeast, northeast. These are the sub directions. Okay, so 8 northeastern states are situated or located in this region. Okay, in this direction. So all the northeastern states are located here. So in this line it is asking a question that which are the 8 northeastern states of India. So I have written down all the 8 northeastern states here. I am going to read out aloud. It's Arunachal Pradesh. Number 1 is Arunachal Pradesh. Number 2 is Assam. Number 3 is Mizoram. Number 4 Manipur. Number 5 Meghalaya. Number 6 Tripura. Number 7 Nagaland. And number 8 is Sikkim. So these are all 8 northeastern states of India. Children, when you will look into the map of India and you will point out the northeastern direction in the map, you will be able to see all the 8 northeastern states in the map. All right, so children, one main fact, or I am going to tell you a GK question about the 7 sisters which we have in northeastern region. So from 1 to 7, all the states which are given here, these are called as 7 sisters. Okay, these all the states, 7 states, that is Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Mizoram, Manipur, Meghalaya, Tripura and Nagaland, all these states are known as the 7 sisters. And Sikkim is called as the brother of these 7 states. Okay, these 7 states are also known as 7 sisters, and Sikkim is known to be the brother of all these 7 sisters. So this is a fun fact of GK which I have told you. So let's move further. Read on to find out more about one such state. One such state means that this Sikkim. One such state is Sikkim. Okay, so we are going to read in this chapter about Sikkim. Okay, where it is located and how many cities are there in this state and what is it's famous for, how people are living in this state. These questions we can solve it by reading the chapter. So what kind of food people eat in this state? What festivals do they celebrate? So all these answers we are going to get when we are going to read out the chapter in detail. All right. So let's move further with the paragraph. When Riya reached her school in the morning, she found a new girl sitting on her seat. So Riya is a girl. When she came to school in the morning, she found that in her seat a new girl was sitting. So Riya smiled and sat next to her. So as you already go to school, when you were going to school, this is now a past tense, now you are not coming to school, but in earlier days, in last year, you used to go to school. So when you see a new boy or a girl in your class, you introduce yourself, you ask the introduction of that newcomer in your class. So similarly, Riya also did. Riya smiled and sat next to her.
Soon the teacher entered and introduced the new girl to the class. So when a new child or a new classmate comes to your class, so the first thing before starting the class, the teacher introduced the new girl to the class. Okay, so teacher, this is what it is written with colon and teacher, that is, this paragraph has been told by the teacher. Okay, so teacher colon, good morning students. These are the sentences which teacher is saying to the class. Okay, good morning students, I want to introduce you all to your new classmate Bodhi. So the name of the new girl in the class was Bodhi. Okay, Bodhi belongs to Sikkim. So the new girl name is Bodhi and she belonged to Sikkim. All right, so where, in from which state Bodhi was? Bodhi was from Sikkim. Which is one of the most fascinating states of India? So which has come for which noun? Sikkim. Sikkim is a proper noun and Sikkim ke liye which use kiya gaya hai. Okay, Sikkim, which is one of the most fascinating states. So Sikkim kya hai? Fascinating state है बेटा. Fascinating की meaning क्या होती है? Charming, attractive. बेटा यहाँ पे भी आपको दिया गया होगा, ये देखिए fascinating की meaning है attractive, charming. So Sikkim is very attractive state of India. It is situated in India. Okay, situated in the eastern Himalayas. Situated means located. कहाँ पे है? All right. So it is located in eastern Himalayas. Beta, what are Himalayas? Beta, Himalayas are the mountain range. Okay, Himalayas kya hai? Mountain range. And bahut jaise mountain range kya hota hai beta? Mountain range hota hai ki bahut sare mountains line se hon, chote hon, bade hon, highest mountains, thode kam high mountains. All right, so माउंटेन रेंज मतलब होता है कि बहुत सारे माउंटेन्स एक लाइन से हो उसी एरिया में, तो उस माउंटेन रेंज को हम हिमालयास कहते हैं. और हिमालयास के ईस्टर्न रीजन में, फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल ये हिमालयास है, ये बहुत सारे माउंटेन्स हैं एंड ये पूरे माउंटेन्स को हम हिमालयास के नाम से जानते हैं. दिस इज़ द माउंटेन रेंज विच इज़ कॉल्ड हिमालयास. सो हिमालयास के ईस्टर्न रीजन में सिक्किम लोकेटेड है. यानी ईस्ट आपने पढ़ा ही है कि ये देखिए ये फोर डायरेक्शंस है ना, हेयर इट इज़ ईस्ट. अगर यहाँ पे हिमालयाज है तो इस रीजन में, ईस्टर्न रीजन में सिक्किम लोकेटेड है. ओके, सो ये आपका मैप दे रखा है बुक में सिक्किम. सो सिक्किम का मैप है सिर्फ. ओके, सो सिक्किम के इधर साइड हिमालयाज होंगे. ऑल राइट, हिमालयास क्या है? माउंटेन रेंज, यानी बहुत सारे ऐसी रेंज जहाँ पे बहुत सारे माउंटेन्स हैं. सो हिमालयास इधर होंगे और हिमालयास के ईस्टर्न एरिया में सिक्किम लोकेटेड है.
इट स्ट्रेच्स बिलो कंचनजंगा. बेटा कंचनजंगा इज द नेम ऑफ अ माउंटेन एंड इट इज द थर्ड हाईएस्ट माउंटेन इन द वर्ल्ड. ऑल राइट, सो लेट्स रीड आउट दिस सेंटेंस अगेन. सिचुएटेड इन द ईस्टर्न हिमालयस. What is situated in eastern Himalayas? Sikkim. We are talking about the state Sikkim. So Sikkim is situated in the eastern Himalayas. It spreads. It is also for Sikkim state. It spreads below Kanchenjunga. Kanchenjunga is a mountain. Okay. And Kanchenjunga is proper noun. The third highest mountain in the world. Kanchenjunga is the third highest mountain in the world. So children, I am going to ask you a question, that which is the highest mountain peak in the world? So the answer is Mount Everest. Okay. So children, here we end our session. I am going to read out, I have already read out the first paragraph. Only this much we are going to do in this session. And children, tomorrow we are going to move further with the next paragraph. Till then, your homework is to find out all the capitals of this state, 8 eastern states. I have already written down all the 8 states here. Okay, so your homework is you have to find out the capital of all the northeastern states which are mentioned here. All right. So thank you so much, children, and have a nice day.